a women's football tournament between two university teams. Nothing extraordinary, you might think. But this is the Islamic Republic of Iran. As many of these young women decide who to vote for, just playing the sport they love is a political challenge.
Actually, there are a lot of problems, such as the lack of investment in women, and they have problems when they want to attend foreign competitions as well. And hosting is not very good because not all the women in the world can play with hijab.
This is the first big test of how Iranians feel in the wake of reformist President Hassan Rouhani's landmark nuclear deal with world powers and the lifting of sanctions. It's been a genuinely hard-fought campaign between rival candidates. And unlike many parts of the Middle East, Iranians are facing a choice of two very different rival political visions.
In Tehran alone, there are roughly around 1,000 candidates seeking around 30 parliamentary seats. And you see their fly posters and campaign literature pinned up on walls all over the capital. The reformists alongside the conservatives, both of them seeking the attentions of Iranian voters.
Dr. Parvaneh Salashouri is one of eight female candidates running as a reform candidate.
Most of the women, they vote for us, and most of the girls, they want better future. They are educated, but they don't have enough resources. They don't have enough opportunities. You know, the discrimination is too much here, and the laws are all against us.
Hardline and religious conservatives dominate the current parliament. If they extend their grip, it will have huge repercussions. They'd make it difficult for reformist President Rouhani to continue his foreign policy of cooperating with Western powers like the UK on everything, from the war in Syria, the country's nuclear program, and economic ties. Conservative candidates have come to this shrine to spread their message that Iran must keep Western influence and power at arm's length.
We can have very friendly relations with countries that accept our sovereignty and independence. But if countries behave arrogantly towards us, we will react and we will say no to them.
Tomorrow's vote is about more than just selecting Iran's next parliament. It's also a referendum on the reform program itself, whether the country's new relationship with the outside world can hold. Raghi Omar, News at 10, Tehran.